extreme flash flooding continues to wreak havoc in far north Queensland as we go to air this morning, leaving residents stranded overnight, more than 14,000 properties without power, and freshwater supplies in Cairns almost bare. They're due to run out in just a few hours. Let's bring in Cairns Mayor Terry James and Queensland Police Deputy Commissioner Shane Chelepy. Terry, Mayor, to you first. This is the largest flood Cairns has ever experienced. Can you bring us up to speed this morning? We understand around 18 people spent the night on roofs across the region. What efforts are being made to rescue those people this morning?
Sylvie, the situation eased a little bit last night and the first responders were able to get in there. The majority of people who wanted to be rescued have been rescued from particularly Machin's Beach, Holloway's Beach. They're continuing with that effort as we speak. But the situation, the rain has eased a little bit and it's allowing our people to particularly get into the Copperload Falls Dam intake, and they're on site now, and hopefully we'll get that water situation rectified before the deadline of around 10 a.m. this morning.
We'll get to the water in just a moment, but which areas are of most concern this morning and are lives at risk as we go to air today?
The most concern is the Machin's Beach, Holloway's Beach, Yorkeys Knob area, which are very close to the Barron River, which again is expected to see a lot of water through that system today because the water's coming down from the Atherton Tablelands to reach us. So that's the concern. But as I said, those particular two areas, Machin's Beach, Holloway's Beach, people who wanted to leave have been rescued there. And now we're working on other areas. So the roads are still cut, so it's very hard to get people in there, in and out. But we're expecting a lot of assistance from emergency services, SES, are being helicoptered in today.
Well, it's a race against the clock today to get debris out of the water treatment plant in the area. Are you confident that you'll be able to do that before the water runs out? What's the message to residents on water?
Please conserve water, even though we will get it on today because the crews are there. It'll be a little while before the water gets back in the system. So hopefully that will happen prior to the 10 o'clock deadline. That we were down to 30% supplies last night and cost even less right now. But yes, now that the crews are there, we are confident.
Gosh, it's a big worry. You know, we saw cattle floating down the Barron River yesterday and residents jumping in to rescue them. This is such an enormous emergency that has escalated quite quickly. We'll leave you there, Mayor, for the moment. Let's bring in Deputy Commissioner Shane Chelepy now from Brisbane. Deputy Commissioner, the Mayor just mentioned that more reinforcements will be sent from Brisbane and chop it in today. What's the plan today in terms of sending more support crews?
Yes, good morning. As the Mayor indicated, Machin's Beach, Holloway's Beach is our main area of concern this morning. We effected more than 250 evacuation rescues there overnight. Wow. And we're comfortable that we'll continue in that area today. We are bringing in more emergency services from Townsville with the assistance of the ADF to be able to use their large lift helicopters into Cairns. The other area of concern for me this morning is north of Cairns. We have received reports around Woodjawoodjil. Up that we have people on the roof there at Woodjawoodjil, as well as a neighbouring community nearby. So we're working now. We know those people are safe at Woodjawoodjil. We are in communication with them. We have 8 adults and 1 young 7-year-old child on the roof of the hospital at Woodjawoodjil. To which we're trying to get support. But can I say, you know, the conditions both around Cairns and Woodjawoodjil is very dangerous. We are seeing heavy rain. We still have winds in the area, which is making airlift capacity extremely difficult for us.
Wow. What is the latest information you're receiving this morning on when this flooding is likely to peak and start receding?
Well, as the Mayor indicated, the rain has started to ease a little bit, but we are expecting a lot more rain today. There is a lot of water upstream that still has to come through those areas. So the emergency services will definitely be out and about today. Our message to people are really clear today. If you are safe in your home, please stay in your home today. That is the safest spot for you to be. Please don't be out and about. We are overnight, again, diverting emergency resources from evacuating people from houses to save people who have driven into floodwater.
which must be incredibly frustrating for you, I'm sure. 4,000 people evacuated, 250 evacuations overnight. The job is just getting started. A very busy day ahead, gentlemen. We appreciate your time this morning. Thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome back. We return now with more on the flood emergency in Queensland's far north. This morning, Christmas travel plans are up in the air with Cairns Airport closed as floodwaters exceed levels that were broken in 1977.
Extraordinary shots, aren't they? Let's bring in Mark Olsen, the CEO of Tourism in Tropical North Queensland. Mark, great to have your insight this morning. That runway is closed for the second time in 4 days. We're looking at the pictures there. Do we have any idea how long that the airport's going to be closed for?
Yeah, morning, David. Morning, Sylvia. Yeah, yesterday was definitely one for the history books with record rainfall up in the catchment. Nearly half a metre fell yesterday up above the Barron Falls. So our focus at the moment is keeping the community safe. But as you said, the airport is closed again. They're reviewing that at midday today and we'll get a sense of where we are. A bit of an island at the moment. From Cairns, we can't travel north to our friends in the Douglas Shire. Our northern beaches are cut off. We're cut off on the highway to the south. And of course, both tracks to the Tablelands are also cut off at the moment. So we've got about 4,000 residents had to be evacuated last night from our northern beaches. And they're now staying in our evacuation centres. And today we'll move them into tourism accommodation.
Gosh, it's stunning how much this has escalated in the last 48 hours. And the problem, of course, with the airport is even once water has receded, no one's able to travel around Cairns. You can't get any airline staff in, you can't get passengers in or out. So it is going to take some time to get the airline operating again, I assume. How bad is it across the city right now, Mark? What are people saying to you?
Yeah, certainly. There's lots of footage on Twitter and across the internet at the moment of water flowing in all directions. Our focus at the moment is really on our residents. The tourism industry has been housing the emergency services staff who are doing an absolutely incredible job. But it's been a long couple of weeks of preparation, then ex-tropical cyclone Jasper, and now the flooding. So we definitely do need some help up here. I know the mayors have reached out to the Prime Minister and to the Premier for a bit of assistance up here. We really need to get out and understand what the situation is. We've seen footage of the North Road with some pretty big boulders on it. We know that there's roads cut to the south and to the west as well, but we really need to get out and assess the situation. It'll take us a couple of days to really understand it. So people have got bookings for Christmas and the New Year. Just give us a couple of days to understand where we're at. The airport stood up really quickly. They're assessing the airport, the runway and the lighting system at midday today. It is easing the rain today, about half as much rain today as we experienced yesterday, or a little bit less, hopefully. I drove into work this morning and there was no rain this morning, which was a pleasant surprise and a nice relief after a couple of very wet days.
We're just looking at that live radar shot now, though, Mark, and it's extraordinary how stubborn this system has been. I don't think anyone expected it to just sit there over Cairns, over the far north, for so many consecutive days and dump so much rain. How much, I know it's early days, but how much would you expect this to cost the industry? We know YASI cost just under $1 billion. Debbie was about $500 million. Is it too soon to put any kind of figures like that on it?
It's a little bit too soon to put a figure on the infrastructure. We haven't had a chance to get out and have a look yet, but we can see already in the booking system, we've lost about $60 million of tourism bookings over the last 9 days because of the tropical cyclone YASI news coming in. And then, of course, those couple of days of closures. So it's already having a pretty big hit on the tourism sector. It's having a much bigger hit on our community. Houses inundated. So our major focus at the moment is looking after our community, looking after our workers, particularly those emergency services workers. And then we'll get a chance to really assess the damage today, tomorrow. And we believe it's starting to really calm down on Tuesday. So we'll get out on Tuesday and Wednesday and really assess where the situation is at.
Yeah, and then it's just about taking care and then rebuilding again, isn't it, Mark? Yeah. We really do appreciate your time this morning. We thank you so much. We'll stay in touch with you.
Thank you, Mark. The absolute priority right now, of course, is keeping everyone safe in that region, and we will get an update from the Premier just ahead.